It's bad news. Flight 10 has been canceled due to some issues. It's a bit disappointing, but it should be ready to go again soon. Meanwhile, Blue Origin's New Shepard has experienced a longer delay. Before the big event, NASA is gearing up to announce new astronauts and provide updates on Artemis 2. Let's talk about it all in today's episode of NR Studio. I think everyone is very excited for the launch attempt on the afternoon of August 24th. This is understandable since we've been waiting almost 3 months for this flight, and it's so important for the future of Starship. Initially, everything seemed to be going very well. About an hour before liftoff, the go signal was given for fueling, and propellant began to fill both stages. The rockets were raised high, and excitement built as the countdown grew. But then something surprising happened. Moments before launch, the fueling process suddenly stopped. A hold command was given, indicating a problem. The countdown was briefly paused, and then, about 17 minutes before launch, the situation became more serious when they requested an abort. Gas was seen escaping from the rocket and its systems as fuel was being ejected. The attempt is officially complete. What happened? SpaceX announced on its official channels that it was delaying Starship's 10th flight today to fix a ground system issue. This brief statement suggests the issue wasn't with the rocket, but rather with the launch equipment. This has left many wondering which part of the system caused the delay. Based on several observations and information shared on SpaceX, it appears the primary cause was the spacecraft's quick disconnect, or QD, issue. On the evening of August 24th, workers were seen raising the work platform and making changes to the system. It's worth noting that the QD has not assisted in official refueling for some time, although it has been opened and closed several times for other tasks. The attempt on the 24th may have revealed an issue that wasn't detected in previous tests. It's also possible the issue originated with the QD booster, but this hasn't been confirmed. The BQD was recently replaced to make room for the spacecraft's test system. The piping connects directly to the BQD cover, which could have caused some unexpected issues. It's worth noting that the spacecraft's test system has been disassembled and reassembled twice, increasing the likelihood of errors. This situation demonstrates the importance of SpaceX fully restoring the Massey test site or accelerating the construction of another launch pad as a backup in case of such issues. Another important point is that there is no evidence of any testing of the BQD fueling system after the ship's test pad was removed.
Without these checks, it would have been difficult to detect the problem before the countdown. The good news is that all available information indicates the spacecraft is still in excellent condition. There have been no reported issues with the rocket boosters or spacecraft. This ensures the hardware is in tip-top condition and ready to go. The problem appears to have only affected ground support equipment, so it should be fixed fairly quickly. However, this incident demonstrates the importance of being well prepared to prevent errors. Safety should always be the top priority, but it's also crucial to minimize last-minute changes and cancellations to build confidence. The next question on everyone's mind is obvious. When will the next launch occur? Even Musk addressed the delay, saying, "There are several goals, but the most important thing is launch." SpaceX hasn't announced a new launch time, raising questions about potential delays. The company announced that Flight 10 is now scheduled for August 26th between 6:30 p.m. and 7:30 p.m. Central Time, the best-case scenario would only require a one-day delay. Backup dates are set for the 28th and also in September if needed. This mission is important not just about schedule. For enthusiasts, this shows that we are getting closer to a reusable system. For SpaceX, it's crucial to keep moving forward and stay ahead of the industry. NASA desperately needs Starship to succeed in the IRIS program and future missions to the Moon and Mars, especially as they compete with China. While the results may seem disappointing, they demonstrate the complexity of doing new and original work. Every delay teaches lessons that help SpaceX get closer to making history. Be patient, be prepared, and continue to support the teams working to make this vision a reality. NASA is gearing up for something exciting. They will announce the 2025 astronaut candidate class on September 22nd at 12:30 p.m. Eastern. It will be streamed live on NASA Plus, Netflix, Amazon Prime, YouTube, and X. Selected from over 8,000 applicants, the recruits will spend 2 years in rigorous training on spacecraft systems, robotics, survival, and science. After this training, they will be ready for missions to the ISS, the Moon, or even Mars. NASA is adding more astronauts to help with the Artemis program. This program focuses on extended lunar missions and plans for human exploration of Mars. The timing comes after the retirements of experienced astronauts like Butch Wilmore, Shannon Walker, Jeanette Epps, and Kate Rubin, highlighting the importance of bringing in a new generation to take over. NASA will hold a briefing on Artemis II. There will be a mission overview and science session. Then, there will be a press conference with the Artemis II crew. These events demonstrate rapid progress and broader plans. They also emphasize the crucial role of SpaceX's Starship human landing system. As September approaches, Houston will be the place to get crucial information about America's plans to return to the Moon and ultimately Mars. This event is a must-see for anyone passionate about spaceflight.
Now let's take a look at the latest news on Blue Origin's New Shepard mission. Lately, I've noticed a very interesting trend regarding when major launches are happening. Many Starship flights are happening at the same time as Blue Origin's New Shepard mission. The timing is the same. Blue Origin originally intended to launch New Shepard NS-35 on August 23rd. This date was supposed to be just one day before the highly anticipated Starship Flight 10. However, things didn't go as planned. The vehicle was on the launch pad, but the first attempt to launch NS-35 was delayed. Blue Origin shared on X that they canceled the NS-35 launch today. The team discovered an issue with the thruster electronics. A new launch target is coming soon. While brief, this statement shows the seriousness of the situation and the uncertainty of when the mission will fly again. This delay has a significant impact on New Shepard. One of the biggest challenges right now is timing. If Blue Origin launched after Starship, people wouldn't pay as much attention and the media wouldn't cover it as much. Starship has garnered a lot of attention worldwide, and other spacecraft that fly after it may not be noticed, even if their missions are successful. The problem itself is equally concerning. The problem lies with the thruster's electronic components, which raises serious concerns and important questions. Avionics are the brains of a launch vehicle. They aid in navigation, control, and critical decision-making during flight. If these systems fail, it can cause serious problems. The vehicle could veer off course, fail its mission, or even be destroyed. Fortunately, they discovered the problem before liftoff, but it still means wasted time, additional repair costs, and delays that make it difficult for Blue Origin to continue operating. This setback is significant considering New Shepard's recent history. After a setback in late 2022, the spacecraft returned to flight in December 2023. Since then, Blue Origin has worked diligently to ramp up its operations. Since that return, 12 missions have been completed, including crewed flights. The NS-35 mission was planned to be the 13th, indicating continued progress. Unfortunately, the delay may have stalled that progress and created further uncertainty. Despite the challenges, the mission remains incredibly important and exciting. NS-35 was designed to carry the 200th payload past the Kármán line, the widely accepted boundary for space. The flight is scheduled to carry more than 40 science and research packages. This includes 24 packages that are part of NASA's TechRise Student Challenge. These experiments include work from students, teachers, and university teams. This demonstrates one of New Shepard's key tasks, helping people learn and making it easier for more people to conduct research in space. This makes the vehicle a formidable competitor in the suborbital market, where Halcon competes directly with Virgin Galactic.
You also have to consider the important technical objectives. Blue Origin's Dave Limp emphasized that this flight will use the company's specialized payload capsule and its latest booster. The same combination demonstrated that this capsule could create lunar gravity during the NS-29 mission in February, proving its versatility. The RSS HLG Wells capsule, which was on the NS-35 flight, is Blue Origin's first vehicle specifically designed to carry cargo, not humans. This will be the 5th flight and 21st mission for New Shepard cargo. As usual, the capsule and booster are intended for recovery. The booster will attempt to land on a concrete pad near its launch site, while the capsule will descend by parachute. This way, both are reusable. As we look to the future, the key question isn't how often New Shepard can fly, but whether Blue Origin can actually reach orbit. The company's hopes for orbit hinge on New Glenn, its larger rocket. New Glenn made its first launch in January of this year. Blue Origin has been in development for over 25 years, but progress has been slow. A second mission is now planned for September 29th at the earliest. These continued delays put Blue Origin at risk in the competitive space industry, where competitors like SpaceX and Rocket Lab are moving quickly.
Right now, everyone is watching for the NS-35 launch date and whether Blue Origin can demonstrate its consistent and reliable operation. However, in a larger competition, simply having a suborbital flight won't be enough to gain a lead. Orbit is the ultimate testing ground, and everyone in the industry is watching to see if Blue Origin can succeed. We'll be watching how Blue Origin develops New Shepard and New Glenn in the coming months. That's it for today's episode, and we'll see you in the next one.